blessings, beautiful kings and queens. Ajwa coming to you with another video with an update. So from the last time, the last video that I put up, I went to the other Aboriginal womb circle, and that was the Earth Star Chakra. And that circle was everything. I don't know. Like, and it's just growing, like, the amount of feminine energy in that space. It was something else. It was just something else, okay? At the circle, we did yoga. There was ancestral dance. The ancestral dance went with all the chakras, and I have a printout of the different chakras that we did. Not the dance, but... and it says, in the beginning, it says, I let go of all the things that no longer serve me. The Earth Star Chakra, it says, I am grounded and connected to the earth. The sacral chakra says, creative energy flows through me. The solar plex chakra, it says, I manifest everything my heart desires, for I am confident and abundant. The heart chakra says, I am unconditionally loved. Throat chakra, I express the divinity within me with ease. Third eye chakra, my vision is clear and I consciously create the life I desire. Crown chakra, I am divinely blessed. And the woman who wrote these affirmations for each chakra was from, she's a sacred Afrofusion dancer. Her name is Imani. I'll put in the description below her Instagram. And the dances she taught us were so beautiful. You just had to be there. You just had to be there. It was awesome. When I was on my way there, I was not in the best moods. But just as soon as I stepped my foot in there, I was like, I am home. My safe space. So it's awesome. So awesome. We also did a manifestation workshop, and we did an altar, how to create your altar workshop as well. And it was awesome. It was awesome. What we did for the manifestation workshop, we planted a seed. And it's just the symbolism. And this is one of the curators, Roszella, she told us that we are the pot. Okay. I wrote some notes here, and it says, you need a new water, new light, and a new seed, basically, for the manifestation. The soil is the upper layer. The seeds are the flower, plant, and reproduction. The water is what forms the lakes and the rain and everything. And you are the pot. So we were the pot, and the seed was planted. Oh, great things are coming. And also, we talked about what is your darkness. So darkness is something that hinders you from your progress. The other question, yeah, something that hinders you from your progress. Like, what is holding you back from going forward? I feel like my darkness, I think it's a lot of things, but my darkness is my depression. and the result of trauma that's been in my life. That's part of it. The other stuff, I don't know if I could go into that right now, but yeah, that's part of it. So, also, the other question was how can you use it? Basically, it could be something else too. It could be a habit. Your darkness could be a habit that is not good, but. The Earth Star Chakra is good for people with anxiety. It's good for healers, and healers need healing too. Okay, all you healers out there, I'm sure you know that y'all need healing too. Yeah. Okay. And what I learned also is that comparison is the thief of joy. Joy is the gift of the present moment. And the yoga that we did was also interactive with the theme, the Earth Star Chakra. So the yoga that we did was good for anxiety, stress, depression. And I will put a link in below the yoga instructor that was there as well. It was so amazing. Another update is that I lost 10 pounds and I've been intermittent fasting. And I am on a strict plant-based diet. And I'm feeling great. I mean, there's no bad feeling that I'm feeling right now. My intermittent fasting is a 16 to 8 window. So that means that I fast for 16 hours. And I have an 8-hour period window where I eat. And I've been good. I've been in better spirits. I mean, I'm not gonna say that I don't feel depressed, but I'm much better than where I was earlier this year. Now, if you've been following me from the beginning of this year, you will see a big difference in my videos. Like, in the beginning of the year, I'm sorry, my eyes are itching. In the beginning of the year, I did videos in the dark. And that was real. That was in my moment of my despair. And that is how I wanted to do it at that time. I did it in the dark. What was I thinking? I don't know, but I did. I did it in the dark, and yeah, that's how I did it. But also, I've been doing that. I also walk. I haven't been doing any vigorous workouts because my heel spur has been acting up, and also because of my condition with my back and my leg, and my feet. So, what I plan on starting to do is get some type of routine going. Some type of routine going that I can do that is not going to be strenuous on my back, mostly. Because I could deal with the pain of my feet, but I guess. But I have to get moving. So I walk a lot. And I know my sister will be like, oh, sis, don't want it. But I need to walk because this weight has to go. And thank you, Mother, Father, God. 10 pounds down and I am excited. I'm excited to see myself in the next 3 months. How much I have progressed. Mentally, physically, spiritually. Okay. Oh, and a gift. So from the womb circle, also, I'm sorry, I forgot to put in. I got this, and my sister, Roszella, she makes them handmade. So if you want you a faux, faux septum chain, I'll put her link to her Instagram below, and all the other curators that and vendors that were there at the last Aboriginal Womb Circle. I will be going to the next one on the 29th. I'm excited. All right, I'm excited because y'all just have to be there. Like, you see this video, and wherever you are, just have to be there. I know women that go there, and they're coming all the way from Massachusetts, all the way from Texas, to come to the Aboriginal Circle. Now, how divine is that? How divine is that? Okay, and some of my other, I don't know if I told you in other videos, I got Eternile. She makes organic soap, so I'm gonna put, she was at the last Aboriginal Womb Circle, and oh, it was awesome. So, also, I'm selling jewelry, $5 jewelry, necklace free, and this is one of the pieces that I got being consulted. I don't think there's any more like this in stock, but if you would like to order from me, I'll leave the link down below. And yes, I'm excited for the new year, for not the new me, but the, you know, the me that I'm creating, because only you can change you. And only you can allow people, or allow people to influence you to change yourself. But don't change yourself for anyone but yourself. Like, this wellness journey is for myself. This wellness journey is for myself. And this wellness journey is, I'm doing this for my children as well. Because if I'm better, I can, you know, better, you know, raise my children, you know. And not saying that I'm a bad mom, but I feel like me being well up here can also contribute to a better way of leading my children. Because I look at myself, yes, I'm a mother, but I'm also leading my children and helping them, assisting them as they grow older. So I hope you all like this video. Leave a comment down below. Share your thoughts and share, like, and subscribe. Peace and blessings. Namaste.
2nd year in college right now.
Okay. Sorry, my love.
I think what makes me happiest is when I'm animating.
Tapping into the ability.
Okay, so although a lot of us didn't get to share how we think our affirmation is, hey.
To be present and be there for the souls that I got to connect with. It was just abundance of blessings. So thank you to Roszella, to Mariya, to Noble Indigos. Every time I come, it's like I get recharged, I get remotivated, and I'm just even more grounded. I planted my seeds, so you know, a whole bunch of blessings are about to come. Too many times we are.
God,